I'm Elizabeth Gill, and I'm the mother of Anthony Gill, the 10-year-old inspirational motivation speaker. He was made valedictorian of his preschool graduation class and was asked to deliver a speech, which turned out to be a 2.5-page speech that he memorized within about 4 hours, tops. A few people at the graduation heard him speaking, and they realized this child had something, some talent other than just giving a graduation speech. So they started calling for him to do certain events, the Black History programs, Martin Luther King Day, and so forth. And, you know, he went out and spoke at those events, and his career sort of just took off from that.
Today, I say to you that even after death, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. has remained in our hearts, our minds, and in our dreams. Well, today, friends, his dreams have become my dreams, and they're the dreams of your children. So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, we still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. On November 14, 2008, my dream of equality became a reality. It was on that day as our nation rose up and lived out the true meaning of its creed. One of our children, President Barack Hussein Obama, had been judged not by the color of his skin, but by the content of his magnificent character. The reality of his dream has restored our faith. This, the faith that you should take back home to your children.
Imagine the world without fear.
My first impression of Anthony was I already knew he was a special kid just by talking to him, his maturity, how polite he was. His mother also gave me a business card and a brochure that had Anthony on it, and I read a little bit about it. And in the brochure, it talked about how he was a motivational speaker. So right away, I already knew that I was going to have a leader on campus and someone that the kids are going to look up to. And it made me very excited as a principal to know that we would have someone so special at our school.
In life, I teach Anthony, and he can tell you. We pray together. That's number one. And I teach him to know who he is, a child of God. And if you know who you are, then nobody will push you, and nobody will lead you wrong, because you have a mind of your own. So this is the main thing I'm trying to instill in him. I'm trying to tell him you can be a leader, but as you hear Anthony's speech, some are made, some will never be, and some are born leader. So if he is not a born leader, then I can't push him in that direction, but I can mold him in a way that he could choose the right people to be his friend or to follow in life. That's my main objective with Anthony. And I'm hoping that, and praying that as the days go by, he will be able to be the grandson that I am hoping to see graduate from college.
My biggest message for Anthony in life is that you have to go after the things that you aspire to be, but not just go after them. You have to go after them with as much dedication and determination as you can put into it, because at the end of the day, nothing that you accomplish is going to mean as much if you don't put your full effort into it, you know? And I always tell Anthony, as far as education is concerned, I want you to get the highest education you can possibly achieve. Not for me, not for your grandparents or anybody else, but for yourself, because like I told him, when you achieve that, you know, no one can say, I gave you your education. They probably can say, I paid for your education, but whatever you accomplish is yours to attain, you know, and nobody else. No one can take that from you, nor can they alter that, you know. That's all yours to own. So that's my biggest message for him.
Super excited that I have a speech tomorrow at the Proud Bird Restaurant for the Tuskegee Airmen, and I hope you guys can come and support.
Anthony reminds me a lot of me growing up. He's talkative, he's curious, he reads a lot, he has a very, very sharp mind, and he, like I said, literally can do anything he wants to do with his life. And right now, if you'll notice, he'll come up here, he's going to deliver a speech, but he also plays basketball, he plays football, he draws, he reads, he does science experiments. He's literally interested he's interested in anything and everything that kind of like makes his brain grow a little bit more. Exactly, stimulate his mind. When you guys get a chance to meet him, I want you guys to take an opportunity to listen to him speak. But even afterwards, when he's done, I want you to, you know, to walk up to him, talk to him, and, you know, meet him, because I promise you, he's going to do something very, very, very special with his life very, very soon.
Wings for Wings America. Squawking at the squadron out of Tuskegee, flying B-40s first, top-level planes, then striking with Thunderbolts, B-40 status, then riding in Mustangs, B-51s.
Now, I gave a brief introduction earlier about a special young man, my godson, and at this point, I'm going to let him do his thing, because I've said too much already. So, Mr. Anthony Gill, will you please join me on the stage?
Good afternoon. Standing here in the presence of such distinguished men and women is an honor for me. Let me formally introduce myself. I am a positive force to be reckoned with. I am the voice of the youth as I speak on our behalf. As a proud African-American young man, I stand for the betterment and the uprising of our people. My name is Anthony. Anthony Gabriel Gill. And I am a 10 years old, inspirational, motivation speaker. All right. Stand up. Stand up and be counted. And while you are being counted, be accountable for your actions. Be accountable, men and women, like our fellow Tuskegee Airmen, who stood against racial injustice, hatred, and discrimination that still plagues our very existence. These fine African-American men and women dare to dream. They dare to hope. They dare to believe. strength, courage, faith, dedication, determination, and unity. See, they overcame and they achieved. It is because of the many accomplishments of these men and women that we are here today. As they persevered against obstacles and adversities, they united themselves within the United States Army and became not just officers of the Army and Navy, but they became officers of hope as they took for the skies. Commanders, lieutenants, and generals, just to name a few, these proud African Americans took our hopes and dreams beyond that color line. Today, we are here to celebrate and give honor to the life and the many accomplishments of Tuskegee Airman, Mr. Roger Bill Terry. Freedom is not free. It often comes with an alarming price. This is a price that Mr. Terry knew all too well. On April 5th, 1945, Airman Roger Terry, along with 161 other airmen, protested the segregated whites-only officers' club at Freeman Field. In an attempt to stand against racial injustice and discrimination, Roger Terry brushed past the white officers and proceeded into the hall. It was this act of bravery that subsequently made Roger Terry one of the unknown victims of the Civil Rights Movement. This man of honor was degraded to a convicted felon, a sentence which lasted 50 years of his life. His rank was reduced and he was generally discharged in November 1945. Unlike a broken soul, Roger Terry did not diminish in character, nor did he play the role of a victim. Instead, he held his head high. He continued to stand against the forces of racism and injustice. It is our time to continue the stand for freedom, equality, and justice. It is time for you to continue on the path to build your legacy. The fight of our forefathers, the Tuskegee Airmen and Tuskegee Airmen, Mr. Roger Bill Terry, cannot diminish and die, nor should it go unnoticed. This is our time. It is time to put into action the steps that subsequently will show gratitude and appreciation to the legacy of Airman Bill Terry. The legacy, the name, the sacrifices, and the accomplishments of Mr. Terry live on. Remember these words. Some are called upon to teach, many are designed to be followers, and few are destined to be leaders. As you teach, remember to instill the values of lifelong lessons. As you follow, be reminded that your actions are being watched by those who know to you as a leader. To the few distinguished leaders, be reminded that as you are called upon to lead, you have a responsibility to inspire, motivate, and influence the choices that will create changes for our tomorrow. All right. Remember my name. I am Anthony Gabriel Gill, and I am the youngest official member of the Tuskegee Airmen of the Los Angeles chapter. Phillips, happy 105th anniversary. Distinguished members, fellow Tuskegee Airmen, in honor of Mr. Roger Terry, I you. Thank you. God bless you. And may God bless the United States of America.
And we're here being honored at the St. Philip's Church. And my youngest member of our chapter is Anthony Gill, and he invited us to come here. And we're honoring Mr. Roger Bill Terry because he was one of our Tuskegee Airmen, and he was a very prominent hero in his own right, Freeman Field Ruby. And so we're just here to support his memory and to support Anthony.
And my name is Simeon Ginyard. I'm the Motivational Officer Director of the Hall of Standards Chapter. And it's a pleasure being here at this event today for the luncheon for the church, 95 years old. And I'm so proud to see that our future president, Mr. Anthony Gill, I'll say of our chapter, and our future president of the United States of America.
Could be.
I believe he will. I believe him. So, Anthony, I'm so glad to be here to support you here. Our chapter is behind you. We have your back. We're proud of you. Keep on doing this and motivate these kids for the future. You are our future. You are our future. So we love you and God love you.
My name is James. Proud to be a Tuskegee Airman. I'd like to echo to what the president and the PR man saying about Anthony. We have to support him, and he is our future. May God bless him and keep him.
Did that young man give a speech or what? He had us riveted as we listened to the importance of knowing our history and standing up and continuing the tradition of the leaders in the movement. So thanks, Anthony, for all that you remind us about, for all that you represent, and we look forward to working with you for many years to come. God bless.
Anthony's message was inspirational. It made me smile. It made me emotional. I'm very, very proud of him as a godfather. I look forward to seeing what he has to do in the future, and I know that he'll do nothing but positive things with himself.
Here at St. Philip's celebration, 105 years. It was amazing, and one of the key highlights of the event was having Anthony speak. He is amazing. I've never seen such a small, you know, child be able to speak almost like he's, you know, been through this life already and back. So he's amazing. He's got wisdom, and I know that God has some great things in store for him, so we have to watch out because he is going to be a force, like he said, to be reckoned with.
My beautiful godson, I'm so proud of him. He really touched my heart. I only wish him the best, and I know for a fact that you would do well in life. You inspire people at that age of 10. He inspires people. He's very loving, smart, and love you, baby. Come here, give me a hug.
Love you.